Well, it's good news for those who support the Second Amendment. It looks as though Republicans and the President of the United States are stepping back from any more gun regulations. Hey, everybody, I'm Chad Hasty, host of the Chad Hasty Show, which airs weekday mornings, 8:30 to 11 a.m. Central Time on News Talk, 95.1 FM and 790 a.m. KFYO. What we're seeing develop in the U.S. right now regarding the gun issue is why I am glad, by the way, that lawmakers in Congress did not hurry back to D.C. and come back from recess to address Second Amendment issues and the gun issue and gun control, as is very clear what the Democrats want. The headline today from Politico: Republicans start to sour on gun control laws after Trump's reversal. Senate Homeland Security Chairman Ron Johnson casting major doubt on the prospects of significant gun regulations passing this fall, the latest sign that an effort to pass new firearm laws is starting to falter. The Wisconsin Republican said that a background check measure based on a bill written by Pat Toomey and Joe Manchin, a Democrat out of West Virginia, and a national red flag bill are both unlikely to pass. He was open to GOP Senator Lindsey Graham's bill that would establish red flag grant programs, but said the Senate would need to attach varying grants or very strict grants and strict guidelines in terms of due process. President Trump has not ruled out anything, but did tell reporters that, quote, a lot of people that put me where I am at are strong believers in the Second Amendment, and I am also. We have to be very careful about that. You know, they call it the slippery slope. All of a sudden, everything gets taken away. Trump told reporters, we're not going to let that happen. Hopefully, listen, I understand that there are a lot of national polls out there that say red flag laws are supported by like 70%, 65% of the public. Red flag laws, the idea behind red flag laws sounds great. It sounds awesome, and it sounds like it makes sense, but they can be abused. And we have not seen a case yet, I don't believe, where a red flag law would have prevented any one of these people from carrying out a mass shooting, especially in El Paso and even in Dayton. I don't think a red flag law would have played a part in this. Red flag laws can be abused. Like all laws, red flag laws can be abused, and you have a right in this country not only to defend yourself, but you also you are innocent until proven guilty. With red flag laws, listen, you can be presumed guilty, and then you have to prove your innocence. It's a reversal from where we stand normally in the judicial system. So I have some real concerns about that. Listen, in practice, red flag laws make sense. Dangerous people should not have guns. I'm all for that. I've got no problem with that. I don't want someone who's beating their wife to have a gun. I don't want somebody who is threatening to go and commit a mass shooting to have a weapon. But we have to be careful. We have to be smart about all of this. And we have to realize that without rock-solid due process laws, that this can be abused in the future. What if you post a picture of your gun on social media and somebody who hates you on social media, calls the authorities and says, hey, this person's going to a gun range. Listen, I had a wacko who was on my Facebook page. I had posted that me and a buddy went to a gun range, here, local gun range here in Lubbock, Texas, just to hone our skills and to practice responsible gun ownership. And we weren't the only ones who were there. And this person went off on me on Facebook for saying, in today's climate, how dare you go there when you're the type of people carrying out these mass shootings? Well, I've never carried out a mass shooting, and nobody I know will want to carry out a mass shooting. We're practicing responsible gun ownership. But under a red flag law, it's entirely possible that that person could have called the authorities and said that I'm a danger to the community because I had guns and because I went to a gun range to practice the skills. When it comes to expanded background checks, again, it's a great idea. We have background checks. We have tough background checks. But this gun show loophole, it's a bunch of BS. What the Democrats have proposed would make it illegal for me to let a buddy of mine borrow my gun to go to the gun range. It would make it illegal for a father to pass down a gun to his son. That's absolute craziness, and there's no way that needs to pass. Emotions have come down a little bit on the Republican side. The president, I think, has started to see that the measures that have been proposed by the Democrats would have had no impact whatsoever on what happened in El Paso and what happened in Dayton. The guy in El Paso was a racist maniac, a domestic terrorist, if you will. I've got no problem saying that. But a red flag law would not have prevented anything, and an expanded background check would not have prevented him from carrying out his attack in El Paso. You want to protect yourself. You want to be able to defend yourself. Become a responsible gun owner. And I know this is unpopular to say, and I'll probably get a few people commenting on the YouTube page more guns isn't the answer, and that I'm a crazy conservative. Be able to defend yourself. Be able to defend yourself in any type of situation. I'm not telling you right now that you'd be able to take down a mass shooter, but I'd rather be armed with a gun if God forbid there's a mass shooter in my area than have nothing at all. And that is just a personal preference of mine. You have a right to defend yourself in this country. And by the way, the Second Amendment is not just about defending yourself or hunting shooting hogs or anything else. It's about protection of tyranny from a future government. Tune in to the Chad Hasty Show weekday mornings, 8:30 to 11 a.m. Central Time on News Talk 95.1 FM and 790 AM KFYO. Have a great day.